Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Portugal. And Biking Man Portugal 2019. Are you excited?
We are.
I'm excited. Omar, are you excited?
I'm really excited.
Yeah?
I'm ready for it.
Did you sleep?
6 hours, hopefully.
Oh, that's not bad. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I've got more old friends here. Jacques, tu vas bien?
Hey, go.
T'es en forme? T'es bien dormi?
Yeah? Dormi moyen parce qu'il y a du bruit.
Go smash it. Go smash it.
Il y a eu du bruit.
And we've got more of the turn cycling guys here. I've got John. Hey, John, how you feeling?
Good.
Okay, good. Sleep well? Sleep well?
What sleep?
Right, let's go do this. Anders.
Yes.
Anders, you ready?
I'm ready.
I've got Anders here somewhere.
Yeah?
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Good. Anders was born ready. Right, let's go and see who else we can find. Say hello to. Conditions are perfect. It's quite a pleasant temperature. No rain in the forecast, so we've ditched the waterproof for just a windproof, which is good. We have Kat here. Kat, can you say hello to everybody?
Morning.
We've got Kat here. Hey, Kat, are you feeling ready?
I'm feeling ready.
Yeah, did you sleep well last night?
No, there was a party in the hotel.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Sucks. What time did that finish?
Maybe 10.
Did you 10 o'clock?
Yeah.
My word, that's outrageous.
Jerks.
Did you go and join them?
I did not.
Oh, well, never mind. Right, we've also got Adam and his brother Paul here. How are you feeling, guys? If I can get you all in shot there. Did you get any sleep at all?
Absolutely, slept like a rock.
Excellent. Well, that's good.
He slept, I didn't.
Oh, no.
He snored, I didn't.
Well, look, good luck, guys. Go smash it. Don't drop each other on the first climb. Stay together and have a great race. Right.
Cheers, buddy. Watch out. Hey, Neil, how you doing?
And I've got Rob
you
here.
Good?
Yeah.
Ready to go, eh?
You ready, Rob?
I'm ready. Ready
good.
To go, yeah.
This is going
to
be a walk in the park after Peru.
No. Never a walk in the park.
Yeah. Are you going to go all the way through no sleep?
No, I'm going to bivvy.
Yeah, but he's a 70-year-old. They don't sleep when you get to 70, do you?
Yeah,
you don't sleep. You need like 2 hours of sleep.
You need a lot of sleep.
Right, well, look, good,
yeah,
Rob. Good luck, Rob.
Yeah.
Go smash
and you.
It.
And you.
Yeah, thank you. Right, let's go and see if we can see anybody else hiding up this end. No, we can't. We're pretty much at the end there. Say hello, everybody. Yay, you all ready?
Yeah.
Good, excellent.
You were hiding away somewhere.
Hey, Eddie. You
see, there are a lot of riders. It is going to be a busy race. It is going to be a busy race. Now, we have the Amani boys here. Ah, this is who I was looking for. Good morning, Maz. Are you feeling ready?
Yeah.
Did you sleep at all?
Oh, is this recording?
No, this is live.
I just managed to get some sleep. Yeah.
There wasn't a party going on in your hotel?
No.
Good. Well, look, good luck. You work hard for this.
Okay.
Take it steady. Don't go out too fast. And let Ahmed do all the work.
Okay.
Good. There we go. Right. Yeah, and we got the Amani boys. And Ahmed, who's riding with Maz. Are you going to go out too fast again? Slow. Okay, slow. I still think I'll find them asleep on the side of the road about 8 hours in. Right, I think that's it. This is the start line. Let me give you a look at that. Well, here we got Hella. Morning, Hella.
Hi.
How are you doing? Did you sleep?
Yeah, I slept really well. 5 hours, complete deep. I feel amazing. I feel fresh.
Good, excellent. Yeah. Are you ready to smash this no sleep?
I'm not sure about smashing it, but yeah. I'll try to sleep as far as I can.
Excellent. And can I just say, that's a great kit.
Isn't it just?
Yeah, love it, love it. That was actually... I'm going to have name freeze now. Oh, no, he's going to kill me for that. I'm going to look that up later. Right, I'm going to go and get ready. Let's do this. Good morning, everybody. And welcome to beautiful, sunny Portugal. I am live at Biking Man 2019, Biking Man Portugal 2019. And we are about nearly 4 hours in. Sorry there's been no video so far. It has been what I can only describe
was a savage start. 4 hours in and we've done nearly 2,000 metres of climbing already in the first 95k. Went off like a steam train. Everybody smashing it up the first climb, which had pitches of up to 15%. And it's just been unrelenting ever since, up until about half an hour ago. So, man, tough, really tough. And now we're in the interior of Portugal, and there's pretty much nothing. It's not even like France, where they've got loads of towns which are just shut. Here, there's just nothing. But it's really pretty. Let me try and show you. If I can try not to crash. Anyway, good morning, Matt. Good morning, Graham. Good morning, Andrew. Welcome to the show. That's an unbelievable start. Still can't get my head around it. Probably, I don't know, somewhere in the top 20 or 30. We'll find out soon enough who's gone out too quickly and who's got the pace to keep going through the night. It should get a bit easier now for most of the way to CP1. I think we're coming out of the hills now, and all the steep gradients should stop. I mean, I saw 16% at one point, which is horrible. 4 hours into a 45-hour ride. It's not what you want to see. Good morning, Dawn. Yes, Matt, another Neil adventure to follow. You'll be pleased to know, everyone will be pleased to know, in my saddlebag there is a rear derailleur hanger, just in cases. I hope I don't need it, but it's there. I won't be stuck for 4.5 days somewhere. Right, my arm's getting sore now, so I will see you all later. Just let me quickly show you what I can see. Oh, hang on, let me lift it up a bit. It is really stunning. We had the most amazing sunrise over the mountains just as I came to the top of the first major climb. It was amazing. We all keep asking ourselves, why do we do this? And that's the reason why. Right, I've got a race to race. Catch you later. Bye. Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Portugal. I'm live at Biking Man. And I've got somebody very special here. This is Leo.
Bambo!
For anybody who watched the Inca Divide, Leo was the star of the show in his flip-flops, which he's still wearing, and his steel cargo bike, or steel bike with amazing backpacks. He's crowdfunded his trip to Portugal. This is your new bike. He's on a new pink bike. He is a legend. Kerry says hi.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
She says, yay, Leo. Awesome to see this guy here. And I'll tell you what, despite the fact he's on flat pedals and sandals, flip-flops, he's a machine. He goes up these hills. It dropped me earlier anyway, that's for sure. Amazing first 5.5 hours. Totally brutal. Done nearly 2,500 meters of climbing. Just so much steep ups and downs. It's now getting hot. It's windy. Whew. Tough day in the office. But it's going awesome. Really enjoying it. The legs are shouting at me a little bit at the moment. They will do all through the night, I imagine. Yeah, it's going well. I think everyone's going well from the Turn Cycling crew. I've had no messages saying help, yeah, which is good. I know one guy's had a crash. I don't know if he's carrying on or not. Some very narrow, twisty descents this morning on some rough country roads. Hello from Yorkshire. Hello to Yorkshire. Are you getting ready for the Worlds? Hope so, should be good. And have I got lots of food? Yes, I've got loads of food. I've got food to get me all the way through to CP1, which is a kilometer 335. So I've already had a meat toasty pasty thing. I've got another one to go. I've got Snickers, I've got M&Ms, I've got Oreos, but I need to stop in the next town for water. So I managed to go 6 hours on 2 litres, which is pretty good, but I do need some more water. Right, I hope you're all enjoying. I will continue to deliver the goods for you, and I'll see you on the road. Catch you later, people. Hey everybody, welcome back to Biking Man Portugal 2019. Let's have a look. Ooh, it's 2:15. I am nearly 9 hours into the ride. I've done 210 kilometers and 3,300 meters of climbing, which is it's pretty tough. It's not hot, but the sun is really bright. Getting a lot of fluid in is the main challenge. So yeah, the aim at the moment is to try and be efficient with the stops, get enough water into the bottles and into the pockets to keep me going for a good 2 or 3 hours. So I've literally just stopped in Serpa. Quick splash and dash, packet of crisps, can of Coke, drank those at the table, filled my bottles, and then on the way again. Yeah, glad you caught me, Ruth. Hey mum, how you doing? Tough day. Well, tough course. Trying to not, I feel good, I feel really good, but I'm trying not to get carried away, because it'll all be down to who rides through the night, basically, and who copes well with riding through the night, and who struggles. So I've got to both conserve my energy for that and make sure I'm fully stocked up with food. I've already identified a McDonald's that's probably open till midnight that I might get to in time, and I know where I can get water at about 2 in the morning. So I just need to find a supermarket sometime around 8 o'clock tonight. So maybe checkpoint one, or maybe a bit before that, just be on the safe side. I think I'm up to about 12th or 13th in the solos, which is good. I seem to overtake people when they stop, because I never really pass anybody on the road. But never mind. Ruth, you don't need to eat for me. I'm eating enough for myself, thank you very much. So it's all going good. Portugal's beautiful, hang on. Let me spin you around. So at the moment, I'm just going through just massive olive plantations. Olives as far as the eye can see. That's a lot of olives. A lot of olives. Sadly, I don't have time to stop for them. Right, time to go. Time to pedal this bike and get to checkpoint one, which should take probably another 5 hours or something. We've got about 125k to checkpoint one, so hopefully 5.5 hours to get there. We'll see. Right, see you later, everybody. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to Biking Man Portugal. I'm joined by a very special guest, none other than Rodney Sonko. Hey Rodney, say hello.
Sim, mais ou menos.
Whatever that means. I'm not being super strong, caught Rodney up. He's just got an injury, so he's taking it tranquilo. Bit of inflammation from a rock that hit him in Peru. But he's looking cool on his new bike.
Yeah. Very moment. Slowly.
Slowly. Tranquilo. Slowly.
And hey. Holiday.
So you stopping tonight and having a beer?
Maybe. Yeah.
I wish I was going to stop and have a beer. It's, well, we're having a great day. We are smashing it. Well, I'm smashing it anyway for me. 250 kilometers in. 246 in... look, 10 hours 21. So we're riding for on the go for 11 hours now, and doing pretty good in terms of efficient stopping. Overtaking lots of people when they stop, which is always good. So next stop, probably a little town about 40k before checkpoint one, so I get some food for the night. Right, ciao.
I'm still eating, clearly. Good evening, everybody. As you can see, I'm eating. I'm also live at CP1, made it to checkpoint one, 10th solo. What a crazy first third of the race. I don't think that there's ever been a harder first section to a race in terms of the terrain. It was brutally steep at times, especially in the first kind of 100k. I've done nearly 5,000 meters of climbing in 335 kilometers, which is pretty nuts. Average speed of 24k an hour, which is even more nuts. But I'm here, which is awesome. So I'm going to stuff my face with some sandwiches and some Portuguese doughnut or Portuguese tart thingy custard things, and then crack on. I've got a date with a McDonald's in Evora, which closes at midnight, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to make it. There's somebody just arriving as well, Jean-Paul arrive. I'm a bit of a state of shock, really. It's tough, really, really tough. Hi everybody, hi Stefan, hi Ben, hi Dawn, hi Sebastian. Dawn, probably not. Well, I might just sleep for 20 minutes by the side of the road. I actually feel all right. Well, even though the pace has been full on. Just a little bit sore in my legs. You know, my ass is fine. The power output's good. So, and it gets easy. The next section's an easier section, so it's only like 2,500 meters of climbing in about 360k, so much, much easier. There's a long flat section down by the coast. So the plan is Evora for late McDonald's, then there's the next town along, which has got a water fountain, so I'll be able to fill up with water at like 2 a.m. and then just settle in down the coast road and put some banging tunes on and keep turning the pedals. So, right, I better crack on. Thanks all for watching, and I'll catch you all later. Bye. Morning, everybody. Wow, that was a long, dark, tough night. The plan I had worked really well. I left checkpoint one at about 8:15. Made it to Evora for about 10:45. Found an all-night garage to get some food. And then found the McDonald's, so I had some food at McDonald's, which set me up. But then I just got really fatigue set in, so I ended up having to stop 3 times during the night just to cat nap for like, first time was for like half an hour, then 20 minutes, then like just literally 7 minutes, just to get me through to daylight. But daylight's here now. It's been quite an attritional race on the rest of the field as well. So I'm currently running in 7th or 8th somewhere, which is amazing. Challenge is now hanging on to it. But you know, everyone's on tired legs, so. And it was cold as well. We weren't expecting it to be cold, but it got down to 6 degrees coming down the coast this morning at about 5 a.m. And that was just awful, because I'm not really prepped for cold weather. I've just got a jersey, some sleeves, and a thin windproof. So hopefully it's warmed up a bit now. Hopefully as the day goes on, it'll get a bit warmer. And I'll try and hold on to this top 10 position, which would be great. Ruth, I think it's calories, so that counts. Even if it's not, doesn't have a great nutritional value. There's a reason I don't like racing through the night. It's miserable. Really miserable. Anyway, thanks for all the messages, everybody. Really appreciate it. I'm now in a patisserie. I've had one of those custody things. Got a nice croissant and a coffee and a Fanta and some water. Still got loads of food left from the garage yesterday, so I'm all set to get through to checkpoint two. So Dawn, actually the cold was down on the coast at sea level. There was like a real cold fog had blown in from the sea, so that's what was causing that. Up at the tops, it was probably fairly cold, so 8 degrees. So not kind of what we were expecting. We were expecting 12. So I think everyone's probably had a really shitty night, to be honest. Clem's scratched because he's been sick. Marcel doesn't look happy. He's threatening to quit ultra racing again, although we have been here before. Tough conditions throughout. Right, I'm gonna crack on with my food. More importantly, my coffee. I've been looking forward to this for ages. I haven't had a coffee yet all the time. And then I'm gonna ride my bike. Catch you later.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Portugal. Morning three of Biking Man Portugal 2019. Apologies for the radio silence yesterday. Yesterday was definitely one of those I'm the nail days. It was probably my toughest day on a bike ever. I think when I spoke to you yesterday morning, I said that the night had been really tough, just fatigue and having to keep stopping. And I think the effects of that, plus the efforts of Monday morning, just meant yesterday was awful. I mean, had nothing in my legs. And just clung on as best I could through to CP2. I mean, the course is beautiful. Did some amazing things yesterday. The axle surprise was particularly nice. If you like horrific gravel and funny cobblestony bits, or funny kind of corrugated concrete paving. I just managed to cling on to my 8th place at CP2. Quick turnaround there, and then it started to work in my favour because I managed to get out and into the mountains before the weather closed in, which, although it actually wasn't that bad, it did kind of put anybody else off leaving CP2. So I had the most amazing climb in kind of at dusk, with the kind of the mist settling, mist and rain settling in, with just the wind turbines for company. And then it got dark and I was doing this climb, pitch black. All I could see was my light bouncing off the mist and the rain, and the occasional snuffle of a wild pig in the undergrowth. And that's all you could see. And then over the top, you just couldn't see anything. You're descending, like by trying to keep your light to the center line so you knew you weren't gonna fall off the edge of the mountain. And then because of the tiredness, I had to get some sleep. So I found a hotel, got 4 hours of sleep. I was overtaken by Guillaume and Leo in the middle of the night, which I expected. But the sleep meant I could then push on today, protect my top 10 place. And it's a beautiful morning. Look at this. It's just been a stunning ride this morning. Loved it. It's, as I said, it's a fantastic course. Ferociously difficult. Actually living up to the billing of 12,000 meters of climbing. So I think I will have hit 12,000 meters before the 950 kilometers are done, which will be in not long. I only have 70 to go now. I've got a nice tailwind. I've got to keep the foot to the floor to stave off a hard charging Derek, who's having a blinding race. He absolutely smashed yesterday out the park. It was amazing to see. I'll be in Faro in about 3 hours and ready for a cold beer. Anyway, good morning, Andy. Morning, Andrew. Morning, Sebastian. Who else is on? Morning, Mohammed. Why are you calling me Noel, Andrew? I'm assuming that's a mistype. So anyway, yeah, what a great race. It's got a bit of everything, this one. Loving it. Right, I shall catch you all. Hang on, let me spin you around.
It is definitely a great place to come and ride your bike, although a lot of very steep climbs. Right, ciao for now, everybody. Speak to you later.
Hey, everybody. Very quickly, here comes Derek. What a machine.
Live at the finish line, Derek Murray crossing in 11th place of the solo finishers. Woo! Yay! Let's go and have a word with him. Mr. Murray.
Is that McDonald's?
That is my McDonald's. Get your hands off.
I'm on my way.
11th place.
Too much? Too much.
You pleased with that?
I slept too much.
Yeah?
I didn't trust myself yesterday when the weather was looking bad to be out on the road and when it looked like it was going to rain. But I started catching a few of the guys that didn't sleep, so I knew I was doing well. I wish I'd
pushed on a bit. Mate, it's been awesome watching you. And a little bit scary. I kept looking over my shoulder thinking he's going to appear around the corner any minute now. So, awesome, well done.
Cheers,
get yourself, go get yourself a McDonald's and then we'll go for a beer.
I'm definitely going to
Yeah. Hi, everybody. Sorry, I'm still eating at a McDonald's. Welcome to the finish line of Biking Man Portugal here in Faro. You've just seen Derek Murray crossing the finish line in an excellent 11th place. I think he put the frighteners in a few people yesterday as he was smashing it between CP1 and CP2. And yes, I have finished. I finished about an hour ago. What a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant race, brilliant course. Just so tough, relentless climbing, lots of rough roads, just been amazing. Really, really, really good race. Absolutely loved it, and it's just glorious sunshine here. Can't argue with that at all, can you? Right, everybody else is doing pretty well. I shall be back here live at the finish line to catch people as they finish. I think next in from the Dubai people will be Hella, who I think we're expecting around 6 or 7 o'clock this evening. She's got about 100k to go. And then after that, I think it'll be Anders, who has just set off on the final, just left CP2 about an hour ago. So he's got the final set of hills to come through. And we think he might go through the night, so he might be finishing at about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. But I will be back here at that time, although not necessarily with it, shall we say. Right, let me just make sure there's no questions. Yeah, we're definitely going to have beer. Thanks, Dawn. Yes, McDonald's is important. I think because he saw mine, basically. So I finished 10th, Andrew. Literally an hour before Derek here. I was about 2 hours behind Guillaume and Leo. So, super happy with it. Because this is a European race, you get a much stronger field. Had some really good races, and the pace was high from the very beginning. I think I'll reflect a bit on my strategy because, you know, as Derek said, when he started catching people who didn't sleep, and I was one who didn't sleep, so, you know, that needs looking at, because this is such a tough, long course. You know, it's not a done in 35 hours. It's a proper two full day. So we'll get to that more later. And what's next? No idea. I'm going to enjoy this one first, Andrew, and then probably talk to my lovely wife about what's next. Right, if there's anyone you particularly want me to interview here live at the finish line, then drop me a line, leave a comment, and I'll try and interview them. And I'll try and get all the people that we know, and all the Dubai people, and everyone who's a friend of Turn Cycling, and interview them here on the finish line. Catch you later, everybody. Welcome back to Faro and the finishing line of Biking Man Portugal 2019.
I'm here live waiting for Anders Jürgensen to come across the finish line. He should have been here by now, so we think he's got lost somewhere in the last 500 meters. Good morning, Philippa. How are you? Good morning, David. So yeah, we're waiting here for Anders to come and finish. He's got lost, I'm guessing. But it'll be good to see him cross the finishing line. I think this whole course has proven to be incredibly tough. That's the general feeling of everyone crossing the finish line, is what a tough course it was. And really, really spectacular. So, yeah, it'll be interesting to get Anders' thoughts. I've been reflecting on my ride a bit since yesterday, and still, you know, really, really pleased with how it went. Amazing kind of day. For stage one, for me, was really the highlight, because I managed to push really, really hard, even though that made me suffer later. I think what's been really good about this course is it's just that little bit harder and longer than the others to make you think more about your strategy. Pushing through the night without sleep ended up not working as well for everybody as getting, you know, 3 hours of good sleep on the first night. An interesting to look at and consider for the next race like this that we all go and do. Right, well, hurry up, Anders. Where are you?
Just checking. Everybody's awake.
That's Derek causing trouble there. This is what's cool about the finish line here. It's a beautiful day in Faro. The sun's shining. Everybody's starting to collect at the finish line. We got Anna, so we got Derek here. We got one of the deans of the race, Rob Packham here, who we'll have a chat with later. I wasn't around at 5 o'clock this morning to see him come in. And we got John Boone here. John, how are you feeling?
Yeah, I've been better thanks to David.
Yeah, unfortunately, John had to scratch due to issues with his calf yesterday. But amazing to get through day one.
Yeah, I hit CP1 and my was within the pace I wanted to, so I feel good about that.
And CP1, start to CP1 is probably one of the hardest 350k of riding that I've ever done, for sure.
Oh yeah, from the beginning to the end.
Yeah.
The first 100 especially.
Yeah.
If it was reversed the other way around, the first night wouldn't have been up, but even the second night would have been a struggle. But like if that first 100k
of
walls after walls.
Yeah, that's probably the best description of it. Wall after wall after wall, because it was literally like going up massively steep walls. Well, there's still no sign of Anders. Maybe he's stopped to have a little moment to himself, a little cry maybe. I don't know. We'll see.
He's probably got lost in the square.
Yeah, probably has got lost in the square. So also, yeah, we got a load of the other guys here, a lot of the Belgium contingent gathering. Everyone's assembling at the finish line. There's Clemence checking everyone's finishing stats, making sure that the timing's right. We've got the finishing board here. Not that you can see because the reflection's in the sun. There we go. That's the overall ranking. That's mixed solo and pairs.
Let's do the live set for
you. Just waiting for Anders' name to be added at the end. That's where they've crossed the checkpoints. Right, well, given he's not here, I'm gonna end this because I don't want to keep you all hanging on. Just give us a few more minutes, maybe 5 minutes, and we'll come back to you. Okay, goodbye from Faro. Welcome back, everybody. Anders is literally just around the corner. We think he stopped for a cheeky bite of food or something, or a last coffee before crossing the finish line. We'll take you out to show you the finishing arch. Hey Sean, how are you? Hey Philippa again. We think he is literally just out of sight to be on this roundabout. Hey Mum, how are you? there's the finishing arch in all its glory, with everybody ready to welcome Anders through the door. And he's still not there. To be fair to Anders, it is tricky navigating through the last bit of the course. It's through the old town of Faro, lots of kind of tight twists and turns, lots of cobbles. It's not a pleasant finish because you've been sat on your ass for kind of 4 days and or 3 days or 5 days or whatever, and you just get rattled apart by a last kilometre of quite bumpy cobblestones. Not quite Paris-Roubaix cobblestones, but not far off. So he's probably taking it nice and slowly and steadily there. Morning, David. How are you? Has your bike arrived yet? Here he comes. Finally. Here comes Anders. Woo! Yes, here we are, live. Anders Jørgensen crossing the finishing line in 4 hours under 4 days. Woo! No. I got that wrong. Much less than 4 hours under 4 days. 16 hours under 4 days. 3 days and 8 hours. Mate, awesome. Well done. Mate. Yeah, I can see that. Right, so here we have a smelly Anders at the finishing line. How are you feeling, Anders?
Shaky.
Shaky? Did you enjoy that?
Lighter.
Trousers next.
Yes, I got a double pair on.
Now they need to take off your shoes and your socks. There's the table.
Did you enjoy that, Anders? That's the first question. Or do you need a few hours to reflect before you answer that one?
I'm happy I did it, but it wasn't that fun.
What time did you start this morning?
1:45.
So how much sleep did you get last night? Oh man, that's amazing. Proper ultra racing. And highlight? What was your highlight of the course, having just finished?
From the course itself?
Just the highlight of the last 3.5 days.
The planning.
Really?
Yeah.
The planning and getting ready for it, not the actual riding of it.
No, but my game plan was good and
Well, that's awesome. I know you know, beforehand we talked and you were thinking, oh, I'd like to finish under 3 days. I think probably the minute you, or the by the time you got to kilometer 100, you probably knew that this was going to be a very different.
Yeah, no, exactly. So I had to redo the game plan, and I think I made a lot of good decisions. When to stop and when to carry on, and
Yeah, well, you're looking fresh. You don't look like you've just ridden 1,000 kilometers with 12,000 meters of climbing in 3 days and 8 hours. Is that the official time?
79 something.
Everybody will think under 80. Fantastic. Well, that's an awesome achievement, because you know, I think everybody has been surprised by the difficulty, just the unrelenting difficulty of the course. So just amazing.
If you compare to Oman, you had like stretches of 100 kilometers where you could just hammer it, and then it would take 3 hours to 100 kilometers.
Yeah.
Here, that's nothing. If you had a tailwind, the roads were shit, and
Right, now I've actually got Toby watching at the moment. Your knees are still in one piece, Toby. Look, knees are still in one piece.
My big toe is a bit sore, and saddle sores.
I think that's more to do with the heat and the sweat and everything. Right, okay, well, we'll let you recover, we'll let you drink some water, and then we'll let you get some food. So,
good. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you all for watching, everybody. So that's Anders crossing the finishing line. Next up from Turn Cycling, we're expecting Omar probably in another couple of hours. So we'll be back live at the finish when he comes in, and we shall speak with him as well. So thanks for watching, everybody. Catch you all later. Bye.
Live with Omar.
Woo-hoo! Yes. You were too quick there, Omar. You caught me out.
When?
Just then. I wasn't in time to get your whole finish. Here we have Omar live at the finish line. Biking Man Portugal 2019.
It's great. I'm glad to be on a bike. Anyone wants the bike?
You going to stick that on eBay?
You will regret it. Yeah, it's nice. How are you guys?
You can't rest yet. You need to come back and talk to me. You can dump your bike with somebody. Oh. Oh.
Oh. It's okay. That's part of the journey, so.
Right. So, Omar, finish your Biking Man Portugal 2019. How does it feel?
Good. What's my timing?
Your timing?
81.35. Wow, that's 8 hours faster than Oman.
And how did you find the...
It's much harder than Oman, like 10 times harder than Oman.
No.
In Oman we had a tailwind for like the whole 2.2.
No kidding, it's harder. Right, so I've got there's a lot of people watching you here, Omar. Question is, what's the best meal you've had on the race? Oh, come on, you do these things as a culinary tour of the country.
I think Kat had the best meal, and I ate with her, like I said, it was fish with rice. But other than that, we just had chips and rice and chicken, that's it.
Okay, well there we go, Dawn. Chips, rice and chicken is what Omar is saying. Hey, Keith, yeah, Anders finished about 2 hours ago. Right, everyone says, hey, Omar. Ruth says, hey, Omar.
Hi.
So, yeah, harder than a man?
Yeah, much harder than a man.
And talk to me about the first 100 kilometers of the race.
It was beautiful. It was really beautiful. This sunrise with the view. Like, you forget the pain just by looking at the view. So, yeah, I think... The end of the first day was the hardest thing in the whole race. Reaching checkpoint 2 with no food and no hotel there. That was checkpoint 1. But other than that, it was hard. Everything was hard.
There was never an easy moment on there, was there?
Yeah, maybe before checkpoint 2, there was some tailwind. We enjoyed that.
Yeah, but then there was the gravel.
The gravel was not
that bad, not as bad as
the
one stuff. But
the other gravel were in the middle between checkpoint 1 and 2.
Yeah.
That was nasty.
And all of the bumpy
hexagonal
climbs.
I lost so many stuff like, in that section.
But right, well look, congratulations on finishing, Omar. Ruth wants to know how much coffee you drank.
Too much.
Too much? Really? Yeah. Are you going to be buzzing for days?
Hopefully no, I won't sleep. I had 5 hours of sleeping every day, which is good.
That's too much.
No, it's not too much. It's never too much.
Right, well, congratulations, Omar. Amazing ride, as always. Go get some water, go relax, and... we will be back here live at the finish line. I think Kat is due in about 20 minutes. I think she stopped to take a moment in the heat. So we will catch her live at the finish line. Thank you all for watching. Hit us down below with any questions you've got for people. follow us on Facebook to get all of these coming live into your inbox. I've just had the best salad I've ever had. Let me just move into the light a little bit better. There we go. Second. Let's get the light right. There's a little cafe called Woods, which is just next to an amazing craft beer place. And we've just been there for salad. Absolutely amazing. So if you come to and visit Faro, go to Woods Cafe down by the marina, and it's awesome. Right, catch you later, everybody. Thanks for watching. Bye. Well, they're coming thick and fast now. Welcome back to Faro and the finishing line of Biking Man Portugal 2019. We are about to welcome home Kat, who I know a lot of you have been looking forward to seeing cross the finish line. I think she's been back and forth with Omar all day, but took a little bit of a break on the last kind of 30-40k. So we're expecting her just around the corner any minute. Well, at least everyone behind was expecting her. This is going to be another Anders, isn't it? Anyway, hi David, hi Dawn. We are waiting for Kat. She will arrive soon, I hope. Let me go and find out where she is. Is she nearby? Omar, where's Kat?
I don't know. She was 10 minutes behind me.
Yeah, so she should be here soon.
Yeah.
Yes, Dawn, we are waiting for Kat. Say hi to Dawn, Omar.
Hi Dawn. We missed you here, really. She's writing, she's typing. I don't know.
She says, go, 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 Kat. Was Kat nearly here? Are you looking at the tracker there? This is Clemence, who's been sorting out all of the time tracking, but who also raced Corsica with her dad and is going to be in a man next year, aren't you? There we go. Oh, yeah, we'll all get FOMO in Taiwan though, Dawn. Right, where's Kat?
Very near. Enjoying the cobblestone as we speak.
She's probably got a big smile on her face.
Oh yeah. Like, what the hell is that road?
Dawn says hi, Clem. Dawn Barnable says hi, Clem.
Instagram live.
Yes, live. Well, live Facebook. Say hello to the world. So I've clearly got ahead of myself, and Kat isn't actually nearly here. So we may just pause this.
She's checking the road condition as we speak. Figure out why we finished this race on such a damaged cobblestone road. Next, she's enjoying the view on Formosa River.
Maybe.
Very, very good sun.
Maybe
it's 30 degrees now.
Maybe she stopped for an ice cream.
Yeah. Have you seen that shop on the left?
No.
Before.
Do you know, I didn't stop. Right, interesting, everybody. You know I like my ice creams. I didn't stop for a single ice cream on the way around. At all. Not one. Hey Sebastian, how you doing? Right, welcome back everybody. Kat is literally just around the corner, and as the second lady home, the ladies are putting on they're getting the girl power music going, getting ready to welcome her home.
Look at that. Only on biking, you can have this.
Derek's brought me ice cream. First ice cream of the of Biking Man. However, we've got a van in the way. Come on, move.
McFlurry delivery on the finish.
If they're unloading online.
Hey Dawn, hey Mum. Kat's going to suddenly appear.
Yeah, she's here.
Is she? Yay, here we go. Come on, Kat. Okay, go, go, go! Woo!
Yay!
How you feeling, Kat? Yeah. Tell you what, you hold that a second. Hold my ice cream. Well done, mate. How are you feeling? Sorry? Yeah, did you enjoy that? I think everybody underestimated the hills a little bit. Dawn says, woohoo, Kat. My mum says, well done, ladies. And Dawn says, we love you, Kat. Amazing effort. Yeah, what was your highlight?
Hard to think about right now because it was awful. Actually, I like the ending bit.
Right, well, we're going to let you just relax and enjoy and savour the moment. Congratulations, Biking Man 2019 Portugal finisher and second lady home.
Finisher woman! Woo!
Right, we will be back shortly. I don't know who's next, but I'll go and check the tracker and we'll give you more live coverage from the finish line. Unless anyone's got any questions for Kat. I'll let you answer that one quickly. Right, no. Right, we're going to let you go. Enjoy, Kat. And congratulations.
Good evening, everybody. A late one, I know, but we just have Adam and Paul arriving. So, yeah, apologies because Anders and I have been in the pub a little bit. So,
hang on, let's go. Here they are. Let me just clean the lens. There we go.
No, no, it was clean.
No, no, it wasn't. Woo! Axel's clearly been drinking as well. Yes!
Yay! Hey, boys! Yep!
Woohoo!
Well done!
Yes! Awesome!
Come on, Paul! Well done!
Nice gilets, too. I love that. Go on, give him a hug. You've just ridden for God knows how long.
Yeah, and I'm on a bike.
Awesome. Amazing. Amazing. Sorry, the cobbles are really awful. Right, the cobbles are awful. I'm gonna go and talk to these guys now. We saw them cross the finish line. Awesome. Adam. Right, hang on, let me spin this round. Talk us through your crash.
Which one?
Yeah, oh, well, you crashed twice. Now, the more important thing, was there any kind of brotherly disagreements going on? Did you fight at all?
No, we didn't.
Are you sure? I would have fought really badly with my brother. I'd have... He can't get his leg off. Hey, Ruth, how you doing? Morning, Ruth. Is it morning? Yeah, good morning. We've stayed up late to watch Adam and Paul cross the finish line at 20 to 2 in the morning. Amazing performance from these guys. Adam's like crashed twice, really messed himself up badly. Paul was so nervous before the start of the ride. I don't think he knew what he'd let himself in for. So just great to see them. Great to see them cross the finish line. So there we go. Right, I'm going to go and find out how they've done.